Hey everyone, and welcome to Delafox Checks. Today, I find myself in Moreno Valley because I'm gonna be trying out this birria spot called Birrería El Tijuanazo, and they sell birria al sabor de Tijuana. So I'm really excited for this because it's actually been a while since I've tried some birria con el sabor o el estilo de Tijuana. So I hope it doesn't disappoint. My friend that lives in this area is bringing me here and they told me that it's good. And I'm actually over here, you guys, because I went out to a rodeo last night. I went to one of those that Rancho Imperial does. And it was really exciting, you know. I got to see some people ride the bulls. I got to dance some banda music, and I got to drink, which is my favorite part, right? So it was a ton of fun, you guys, but today I'm dealing with the consequences of having done all that, and well, tengo una cruda, right? So let's go to the restaurant and check this place out to see how it is. Right now, we're gonna be checking out the Instagram page for the restaurant, and the name of the page is Birrería El Tijuanazo, and they have over 7,600 followers, and they have three locations, one in Ontario, one in Colton, and one in Moreno Valley, which is the one I'm going to today. And one of the pictures I liked was this one right here, and I like this one because I'm looking at the tortilla, and I like the way it's orange, because it makes me think that the tortilla is dipped in the consomme sauce of the birria, right? So if that's done, it does look like it's gonna be pretty good. And it looks like they put a lot of cheese, and look at the meat, you guys, it looks really good, right? And I'm also gonna be ordering a birria plate. This picture doesn't look that nice, you guys, but I will be ordering the birria plate porque si quiero el caldito para la cruda, para levantarme, you know, I do want something that's gonna give me energy again, so I will be ordering one of these. So we'll see what else they have on their menu when I get there. You know, I don't really come to Moreno Valley that much. I really just come during the nighttime when I come to El Rodeo de Moreno Valley. But during the daytime, I've never really stayed here, only because I'm here with my friend. But like, it's actually pretty nice, you guys. Moreno Valley reminds me of like when I used to live in Lancaster. It has like that little hometown feel to it, right? There's a lot of homes, a lot of townhomes, a lot of motorhomes, and a lot of businesses, and there's not a lot of traffic, you guys. That's one of the cool things that I like about this place. And even when I was living in Lancaster, you know, such a huge difference, like when you live in one of these little towns compared to like LA, right? Like there's a lot less traffic. So that's one of the nice things about traveling and getting to know other places. You see what life is like outside of the city. But right now we're getting to the restaurant right here, and there's actually a Culichi Town on the left hand side. I have made a video to Culichi Town in the past. If you want to check that out, see my recommendations on what you should order, because not everything from Culichi Town is good, you guys, okay? So I do recommend some things in that video, check it out. But right now we're here at the restaurant. It's on the left hand side, Birrería El Tijuanazo, and there was a lot of people, you guys. It was Monday afternoon, you guys, and there was a lot of people. I guess everyone is on unemployment just like me, you know? I mean, there's no shame in that, right? We can't find jobs, you guys. It's not our fault. But anyway, you know, there's a lot of people, you guys. I'm putting my name on the list, and we'll see how long it takes. So the wait time actually wasn't that bad. It was about a 25 to 30 minute wait time. They're understaffed at the restaurant, which is why there was a line, but now we're inside. And I do like those letters right there that say Tijuanazo. They look really nice. They got like this custom banner also of like the restaurant that looks really old school. That was probably when they were getting started. It says Hecho en Tijuana, which is where the restaurant is from. And right here, this is the menu, you guys, and they sell a lot of things. But right away, I'm gonna tell you guys, I didn't like the menu because it doesn't have pictures, right? You guys know that for me, a menu without pictures is a list of things that a restaurant sells. And I don't want a list, I want a menu. A menu should have pictures, right? But anyway, this is the menu, you guys. They got a lot of stuff. They got tacos, quesadillas, los platos de birria. They got party platters in case you need like 10 pounds of birria or whatever, desserts. And I mean, they got a lot of stuff, you know. I'm gonna order, like I told you guys, un taco, un queso taco, el plato de birria, and we're gonna try it out to see how it is. But I mean, the menu needs some work, you guys, but what I care about is the food. The first thing I ordered on my visit era un taco de birria, and take a look at the taco, you guys. Look how good it looks. Look at the tortilla color. It looks so soft. Like, look how much meat they put too. That's one of the things I liked about the taco, you guys. I like that it's soft and that it has a lot of meat and that it wasn't dry, you guys. take a look at the carne, and it does not look dry. I mean, I put some limon, you guys, but the carne is still, like, it wasn't dry, which is something I liked. I would rate the taco a 4 out of 5 because I liked how soft and delicious it was. The second thing I ordered on my visit era una quesabirria, and the quesabirria was really good. I like the way it tasted. Hey, this one had a lot more meat than the taco, which, I mean, you can tell right away, right? And it had the cheese, of course. But one of the things I didn't like about the quesabirria, you guys, if you take a look at it, there's not a lot of cheese on the inside. And that's one of the things that sucked. Like, when I opened it up, you guys, literally, there was not a lot of cheese. And that kind of sucked, you know? They did put the cheese in between the 2 tortillas, but I felt like it just was not a lot. Like, when we go back to the Instagram picture and we see that quesabirria, that quesabirria had a ton of cheese. This one didn't, right? So that's the only bad thing about the quesabirria. It did taste good and everything. I loved it. I just wish it would have had more cheese like the picture I saw on Instagram, right? But I would still rate the quesabirria like a 4 out of 5, you know? 3, 4. Ah, we'll give it a 4. It was a 4 out of 5 because, I mean, it was good. I just wish it would have had more cheese, you know? The last thing I got on my visit today era el plato de birria, and this thing was really good, you guys. I loved it. Like, I like how much consomme I had, especially because I had a hangover. I just wanted to drink the juice, and the juice tasted really good, you guys. Si tiene, it does have that flavor, the Tijuana, which is something I really like, right? I'm trying out a different birria that tastes different than other ones that I like to try, and it was really good. They put a lot of meat in the plate, as you guys can see in the video, and I like the way the meat is broken up into little pieces. Like, they don't give you big chunks of meat, you know, and then, like, you have to tear it apart yourself. They break it down for you so the meat is nice and soft for you. And of course, the puse cebolla, cilantro, and some lemon just to give it that little kick flavor, that little spicy flavor that I like, right? And it was really good. I liked it. I would give el plato de birria a 5 out of 5 because I enjoyed it and it removed my cruda, and I felt much better after eating it. On Yelp, Birreria El Tijuanazo has 4 stars with 143 reviews, and I think the rating that this place has on Yelp is pretty good, and I'm also going to be giving it a 4 out of 5, and the reason I'm giving it a 4 was because I love the birria today. Everything was really good. I'm really happy que la birria de verdad had that flavor, the Tijuana, which is what I was looking for, so I was really excited about that. That's one of the things I like about birria, is that, you know, you can eat birria from different places, and every place is gonna have its own unique flavor because there's just so many different ways that you can make birria, right? That's what makes birria so awesome, and that's one of the reasons why birria is my number one favorite food, right? But of course, this restaurant did a good job. I did like everything. They were understaffed, and I mean, it's understandable. Right now, every business is having a hard time finding employees, and that's because that unemployment money is just too good. But you know, it ends in September, so it's time to go back to work and help these restaurants out, right? But if you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit that delicious like button down below. It helps me out a lot. And also, if you want to keep going on some awesome adventures with me, checking out other restaurants, make sure to subscribe. I post new videos every single week showing you places you're gonna wanna go check out. This was Della Fox Checks, and I approve of Birreria El Tijuanazo.